Now quickly moving to see the conductive aphasia. Conductive aphasia could be a damage to a part of the parietal lobe. The important thing is that the conductive aphasia results from damage the superior longitudinal fascicle, also called the arcuate fasciculus. These fasciculus connect the, let me draw the brain. So here's the brain. Frontal, parietal, occipital, and temporal lobes. The Broca's area is here on the inferior gyri of the frontal lobe, and Wernicke's area is in the superior temporal gyri here. But all now this is Brodmann area 22, and Broca's area is Brodmann area 42. Sorry, 44. Sorry, 44. I think that I made a mistake in other video. Anyway, 44, 22. And sometimes Wernicke's area also includes two gyri on the parietal lobe, that are Brodmann area 39 and Brodmann area 40. This is the marginal gyri, and this is the angular gyri, or gyrus. So, the longitudinal fascicle is connecting the Wernicke's area and Broca's area. So this is the superior longitudinal fascicle. But because Wernicke's area sometimes involves also the parietal lobe, a damage to the parietal lobe can result in conductive aphasia. Now let's see the presentation of conductive aphasia. Conductive aphasia presents with only the connection between the spoken language and the interpretation. So the patient can talk completely normal, is not having a Broca's aphasia, so can talk fluently, completely normal. Also can understand what the other people is saying, can understand completely, but cannot execute spoken commands, like count backward. That the patient cannot count backward beginning from 100, the patient cannot do that, and also, the patient usually has trouble with naming objects. So these are the two things that we see. The patient is, one, unable to repeat the thing, for example, repeat what I'm telling you. Also cannot execute a verbal command, like count backward from 100, and cannot name objects. This is the result of a damage to the arcuate fascicle or superior longitudinal fascicle. That is the fascicle that connects Wernicke's area, Brodmann area 22 on the temporal lobe, and 39 and 40 on the parietal lobe, with Broca's area on the frontal lobe.